Welcome back. Let's do a quick summary of what you learned in lesson 7. So we started with a population, in this case, clout scores. The number in this population was 1,048. The mean clout score was 37.72, and the population standard deviation was about 16.04. Then we know from the central limit theorem that if we took all possible samples, all of the same size, and then found the mean of each sample, and then graphed the distribution of those sample means, we would get a normal curve with a mean equal to the population mean and a standard deviation equal to the population standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. Remember that this is called the sampling distribution. In lesson 7, we specifically looked at the sampling distribution created from all samples of size 35. So if we take all samples of size 35 from this population, we find the mean of each sample, and then we plot the distribution of sample means, the mean of the means will be the same as the population mean, and the standard deviation of this distribution is the population standard deviation divided by the square root of 35, which came out to about 2.71. Remember also that the standard deviation of the sampling distribution is called the standard error. Now if we plot this sampling distribution, it'll look something like this. One standard deviation away from the mean would be 37.72 plus 2.71 and minus 2.71. So we know what the distribution should look like of all sample means of size 35. So then we said, what if we get this sample of size 35 and the mean is 40? And everyone in this sample uses the app the Bieber Tweeter. The first part of this lesson is all about estimating what the mean clout score would be if everyone started to use the Bieber Tweeter.